Just when you thought Democratic politicians couldn't get any more ignorant, Sheila Jackson Lee just took the cake, man. If you don't know who Sheila Jackson Lee is, she's a representative from Texas, 13-term representative. 13 terms. She's been in there forever. And she's trying to advocate legislation that would, I would assume, ban certain ammunition as it relates to an AR-15. She does not even know what an AR-15 is. And she's supposed to be drafting legislation to ban something associated with it. She don't know what an AR-15 is, and she don't know what ammo is. How are you gonna make legislation about something you know nothing about? I can't, this is crazy to me. So for those of you that heard the clip, I'm gonna play it for you. Listen to what this fool says.
My bill that I've introduced dealing with the caliber weapon, I've held an AR-15 in my hand. I wish I had it. It is as heavy as 10 boxes that you might be moving.
An AR is heavier than 10 boxes that you may be moving. Sheila, I know you don't know what an AR-15 is, but this is an AR-15. I'm holding this thing with two fingers. Fully loaded AR-15 with the mag and everything in it. 10 boxes that you may be holding. This is lighter than a shotgun. But Sheila Jackson Lee, swear to God, that thing is that heavy. You clearly have never held an AR-15. Let's continue.
And the bullet that is utilized, a 50 caliber, these kinds of bullets need to be licensed and do not...
A 50 caliber bullet in an AR-15. Let me give you an example of what a 50 caliber bullet versus a 223 look like. Ladies and gentlemen, this is an AR-15 bullet. A 223 bullet, they make 5.56 about the same. This is a 50 cal. How do you mistake this with this? She has no idea what she's talking about. This is a 223 round that's in an AR-15. This is a 50 cal. Two different rounds. But these are our politicians. These are the people that we've entrusted to create and draft legislation to make us all safer. How in the world is she going to make us safe when she don't even know what she's talking about? These are the things that I refer to. People say, oh man, you just, you know, you kissing the white man, but you just trying to be, you know, whatever's trendy, you conservative, you Donald Trump. I think we all can agree that it is asinine that you are going to try to create legislation you don't know nothing about. Democrats have done this more often than not. They call them assault rifles. They're not called assault rifles. AR does not mean assault rifle. For the life of me, they don't know what they're talking about in the title of the gun. Then they don't know whether it's semi-auto or fully auto. AR-15s, similar to Glocks, handguns, are all semi-automatic weapons. They're semi-automatic. Semi means that you have to pull the trigger every time you want to shoot. Fully auto, you pull the trigger and it's going to rattle off. They don't even understand the difference. They also don't understand the difference. They probably do. They're just trying to lie to y'all about it. What's the biggest threat when it comes to gun violence in America? Is it the big, bad, scary AR-15 or is it the Glock? Mind you, most of the shootings, I think it's over 60% of the shootings that occur with Glocks. Not necessarily Glocks, but handguns. Handguns, not rifles. People are killed three times as much or three times more often with fists, knives, and all other sort of edged objects or even, you know, hands than they are with AR-15s. AR-15s are the low man on the totem pole when it comes to the utilization of those weapons to kill people in this country. So if you really wanted to ban or you want to restrict, you would want to restrict the handgun. But they don't care. The handgun, they know they won't get the handgun. But they can trick a lot of you into thinking that this gun is as heavy as 10 boxes and shoot ammunition like this. If they can fool you into doing that, They can start with the big bad rifle. Once they've gotten the opportunity to ban your rifles, then they're going to come for your handguns. And the same measure that they use against the rifle, which are going to be proven to be not effective, they're going to try to use the same thing against a handgun, and they're going to take your weapons. This is not propaganda. NRA doesn't pay me nothing. I'm not run by nobody. This is B. Tatum. As a former SWAT member, it's over here. As a former SWAT member, a former police officer, I'm telling you guys, they're coming for your guns. They want a socialist structure in America that gives government the ultimate power. The people have no power. Once you have no arms, they can do and say and perpetuate whatever they want, and you have no means to defend yourself. None. Not on a local level, not on a state level, and definitely not on a federal level. But this is the type of stuff that they want to interject in your mind and fearmonger you into giving up your guns. I'll say this last point, and I'm out of here. Even if every single law-abiding American, whom most people would not use any of their firearms to kill other people, those firearms that are not going to kill anybody anyway, if they are to turn those firearms in, what difference does it make? What are you going to actually accomplish by people who will never kill a person anyway turning in guns that will never be utilized? The bad guys are not going to do that. I'll say this till I'm blue in the face. Prohibited possessors, felons, people who are hell-bent on killing other people, and crazy people, and I'm saying people who have lost their mind, who off their rocker, whether it's intentional or not, they're not taking medication, they are not going to somehow say, you know what? Beto said we should turn these guns in, that we've spent thousands of dollars for it, they're going to give us a couple hundred dollars. I'm going to risk going to prison for the rest of my life knowing that I want to kill people, knowing that I have killed people, or that I'm a prohibited possessor. I'm going to go and take my gun down to the buyback and risk going to prison because I think it's the right thing to do. It's not going to happen. You're going to get caught with your pants down. The thugs are going to be emboldened because they're going to be the only ones that have guns. If you like this video, make sure you share. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the bell. Make sure you visit the store at The Officer Tatum. store.com. cool, clean merch. I'm trying to think what else. You know the drill. Go to the description section, you'll see all the other cool stuff. Thank you for watching the video. God bless you. I'll see y'all guys on the next one. Peace.